Hi, my name is Dan Kumo, and I'm a program manager on the Windows Core networking team. In this video, we'll talk about a new feature in Windows Server 2019 called RSC and the vSwitch. RSC and the vSwitch improves performance when processing network traffic by coalescing multiple TCP segments into fewer but larger segments. Depending on the scenario, this results in lower host CPU utilization or higher throughput to the virtual NIC. Now let's take a look at how RSC and the vSwitch benefits low throughput scenarios. At the top of the video, we have a virtual machine that will be receiving network traffic from another host. You'll be able to observe the CPU utilization and network throughput inside the virtual machine. At the bottom of the video, we'll observe the CPU utilization required to process the virtual machine's network traffic on the host. And, as you can see, RSC and the virtual switch is currently disabled. Now let's kick off some network traffic. Once the network activity begins to progress, you can observe the network throughput hovering around 11.5 gigabits per second and CPU utilization in the virtual machine around 15%. At the bottom of the screen, you can see the CPU utilization on the host is hovering around 22%. Now let's see what happens when we enable RSC in the virtual switch. In the virtual machine, you can see an immediate drop in CPU utilization despite the network throughput staying approximately the same. And on the host, the CPU utilization has dropped from an average of 22% to approximately 14%. Now let's take a look at a high throughput scenario. Here you can see that RSC in the virtual switch is again disabled. We'll kick off our network traffic again, and the virtual machine begins receiving around 37 gigabits per second, requiring 44% CPU utilization in the VM. On the host, the CPU utilization is hovering around 68%. Now let's enable RSC in the vSwitch again. As you can see, the host CPU utilization drops to about 58%, while the network throughput to the VM is maintained.